Hello guys, so welcome, and today we are going to talk about Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda, an Indian sannyasi who propounded the Indian Vedanta philosophy, Indian culture towards to the Western countries. He was the first Indian, I can say, who made the Western countries to realize that there is something very different from them, from what is with them in the Eastern world, or we can say Orientalist world. So we are going to talk about Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda, he was born on 12 January 1863 and in a caste family in Bengal. His early education was in English, and he had graduated in BSc. So what happened? In 1884, there was after his father's death, so he went into a financial distress because he don't have the money. So he had to support his, as his father was not there, so he had to support his family. For that, he started searching for work, but he was not getting the work. So once he went to his guru Ramakrishna to ask him that he should pray to the goddess. Ramakrishna was the devotee of the goddess Kali. So he told him that Ramakrishna should pray before the goddess, and that the goddess should take all the pain, should take all the pain of the Swami Vivekananda. So Ramakrishna told Swami Vivekananda, if you want to have such things, so you can go and tell the goddess. But when Vivekananda gone to tell, he was unable to tell that, but he became so much. He was not able to ask for that wealth or for the good life, but he asked for Vivek and Bairag. Vivek means conscience and reclusion. And that day was, there was a day when there was a spiritual awakening in the Vivekananda. So after the death of his guru Ramakrishna, Swami Vivekananda, along with the 15, 16 others, they used to beg for the food for the day, and used to eat. They were living in very bad conditions. So Swami Vivekananda started to roam all over India. He started visiting all over India. So when he was in the South India, he found that there was a Parliament of World Religions which was going to be convened at the USA at that time. So he thought of to go there and represent the India's culture, but he don't have that money and all that, so facilities to go there. So once when he was Vivekananda was mediating in South India in Kanyakumari, today there is a temple, today there is a samadhi, during his mediation there was assertion of his feeling that he should go and participate in that parliament of religions, that is in USA, Chicago. So now he make his mind that he will go. So now in 1893, so and he will go, and there he will represent the India, Hinduism, India's philosophies, in Vedanta culture, Vedanta philosophy, Indian culture. So now, as money were raised by the various people, they begged for the money and collected the money, and there was a Raja of Khetri, Ajit Singh, who also paid some money so that he can go there. And he left for the Chicago on May 31, 1873. On 11th September 1893, now when his time came to speak on the dais, so he started his opening line with "My brothers and sisters of America," and this particular line, for this line there was a 2-minute clap in the whole that hall, and that was the only moment when The whole hall clapped for 2 minutes. So, and he gained such a widespread, we can say, he got so famous with these lines that everyone in the world came to know that an Indian monk is something different. So he explained the Vedanta philosophy, spiritual significance, putting the energy on the world religions. And if you want to know what was his speech there, so I had made a video on this also. You will get a link of that video in my description. You can see that. So now he lived there for 2.5 years in America, and he founded the Vedanta Society in 1894. He also traveled to the United Kingdom and various Western world to, and he used to give the speeches and collect some money so that he can have a better life in India and can help his brothers and sisters of India. So now one thing of the Vivekananda teaching was that he said that as the Western world has the wealth and Eastern world has the spirituality, if the both combine, the world will be heaven. So that we both have something to exchange, we can exchange that. That was his best thing, I can say. Now teachings of Swami Vivekananda, if you talk about what was teaching, he after returned to India in 1897, and all over India there was this various people gathering for him. So a lot of receptions, he was treated like someone like God, and he given many lectures in India after that. On May 1, he established Ramakrishna Mission at Belur Math near Calcutta in 1897. Now the Ramakrishna Mission was actually a non-profit organization, we can say, which was to help the poor, to establishing schools, colleges, propagation of Vedanta philosophy across the country. So Vivekananda, if you see, he was a nationalist who wanted the welfare of his country. He urged his fellow countrymen to arise, awake and stop, not till the God is reached. That was Swami Vivekananda. Now Swami Vivekananda had predicted that he will not live till the age of 40. See what the power he had, that he predicted his death. So he was knowing that he will not live above 40, and on 4 July 1902, he went about his day work at Belur Math. He was teaching the Sanskrit, and he retired his room at around 9 o'clock in the night, and he attended the Mahasamadhi. It is said that he attended Mahasamadhi and he was dead, and he was cremated on the rivers of Ganga. If you talk about what the legacy of Swami Vivekananda and what he given to the world and to the India, we can say he revealed the world the true foundations of India's unity. He was only person who made the Western world to realize that in India there is something different from the Western world. We have something different that is not anywhere in the world. And he taught how nation with such a vast diversity can be together by a feeling of humanity and brotherhood. So, and it was various, there are various stories about his days in America. There is such a story that he used to visit a library, and when he was in America, he used to visit the library, and every day he takes good books. Large number of 2-3 good books and go, and in 2 days he returned. So he used to do again and again. So once that librarian, he asked that if you want to see the pictures, I can make you see. Why take so much load and go and again come? So he said that I had read all the books. If I can say that on this page a particular thing had been written. So the thing that how he has such a great mind, a brain, this is because he said that if you are going to If you are studying, or that's for the student, if you are studying, so study without any distraction, so you will get 100%. So thanks friends, I hope if you like it, please subscribe to our channel, like, share.